the fantasy springs. Gonna come in and burn some money.
Hotel and casino. I'm gonna check out this place. Winner, winner.
No, we both
won. Yeah, we both won, but anyways. She won $200 and I only won 56.
But so, we wasted $80.
How much? $80. So with $80.
So we double our money.
Yeah. Ticket redemption, I think 10 tickets.
So we're leaving with $150 more in our pocket. Woohoo!
Yeah.
So it's a win-win.
Yes, indeed. What are your thoughts of the casino?
We never do that.
Yeah, I know. It's
we always
like,
come with empty.
Yeah. Yeah, the first time I bet like $20 and I got all the way to $120 and I lost it all.
Yeah, but so, that's when I won. And then I played, I get the other machine, the second machine we played, I only played $10 and I lost it. So it wasn't that bad. And then the third machine, I only played $10. Oh no, the five I put after $5, so 50. I played 50 and I lost those. So, not bad.
Not bad.
How much did you play?
I play
20 and you won 30.
40.
Sorry, 50.
40, I think $40.
Mm-hmm.
And I won 50, or I got 56, so I got my money back. And,
I think you paid less money than 80
then. Yeah.
Because you said you only had $40, right?
Yeah, I had 40.
And I paid 20. 30, maybe 30.
Yeah, 60.
Oh, it's not that.
Oh, dear. We still came on top. That's what matters. What are your thoughts of the Fantasy Springs?
I kind of like it. I like it better than Morongo.
Yeah.
Yeah. I guess the last time we went, I don't know.
Yeah.
I wanted to win. And I lost.
Yeah, I know every time somebody gambles, that's the whole point of gambling. We all want to win.
And this time it wasn't a plan. And we just came for fun. And we ended up winning.
Yeah.
I think that's the whole point.
Yes, indeed.
What we have to do. Just play for fun. And you'll win.
All right, guys. We're going to continue our trip.
Excursion.
We're in Indio and we're gonna be heading to Palm Springs.
See where we end up.
And see what else do we end up doing.
We're gonna take the 111?
Yeah, exactly. We're not gonna take the freeway. We're gonna get back into the 111, which is
highway.
Like a highway that goes around the side of the mountain. And we'll get to see.
We should have brought our GoPro.
Yeah. All right, peace out.
Peace.
Thank you. many variations of dates. Or what can you do with a date? There it is. This is the almond day roll.
I'm gonna try the coconut. Let me have a bite of that one.
Mm. Yo me lo comí
todo.
Oh my. Sorry. In front of the screen.
Do you
hear
rain
in
the days
worse
than
anything? Oh, really?
These covers are put on the last week in August when the fruit starts to cut and left there until the dates are all picked. The dates begin to ripen about the 1st of September, and from then on until Christmas, the fruit is picked once a week. A bunch of dates cannot be cut like a bunch of bananas. Inasmuch as all of the dates on a bunch do not ripen at the same time, they must be picked individually as they ripen.
Wow.
After the dates are picked, they're thoroughly cleaned, graded, and packed under the most sanitary conditions. We do the preliminary grading on a moving conveyor belt. But the final grading is always done on paper. We find this to be the only way accurate grades can be maintained. In fact, odd as it may seem,
thank you. What are your thoughts on the shake?
It is delicious if you've never been to Shields. And what is this, Indio still?
Indio, yeah.
You should stop by and try a date shake. They also have different types of shakes, but this one is really, really good.
Yeah, I was really surprised. We had tried one. Shit, it must have been about 14 years ago. No, about 20 years ago when our daughter was still a baby. And I think that maybe I was just too picky on food back then, but...
It was. But this is freaking good.
But yeah, it's really good.
Oh, it's been open since 1924.
1924, yeah. All right, guys, we're going to keep on driving around town and start making our way towards Palm Springs and see what else we find along the way.
What our next stop is.
Yes.